Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Late Night Battleground with Zoo Nation. Let's do it. Or something. Play. There we go. Okay, there's a couple things you gotta know. First of all, I'm very bad at this game. I am no good. I'm terrible. All of that stuff is true. I suck at this game, but that's fine because we're here to have fun. But the other thing you got to know is I play with a Steam controller. I do not use the mouse and keyboard because mouse and keyboard is not my thing. I don't play a lot of first-person shooters. I definitely don't play any kind of first-person shooter on a PC. So I've got sort of a joystick kind of situation going on here. God, the sounds. The other things you got to know, I'm not sure if this is even going to record very well because of the sounds. My voice is going to be probably all robot-y and gross because I'm running the sound card through the same thing that I'm recording on. And it's like not going to work out very well. But you can't play this game hardly at all without the sounds because you get snuck up on, you get shot at, can't hear the sounds, all that stuff. So this is all an experimental recording. We're going to give it a shot. I just wish the sounds would stop. I wish the sounds would stop. Please stop. It's going to get worse when we're in the plane, so I'm going to jump as quickly as possible. Okay, where are we at? I'm going to look at the map real quick. Okay, we're at the northwest side of the map. So I'm going to jump east. Southeast. Here we go. Jumping. Fly, I don't know, straight down-ish somewhere around. Maybe I can make it to the gun range, even though, like, there's no way you're going to hear any of this with all the noise coming through. But it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Nothing matters. I just want to end it all. All right. So this isn't normally how I play. Normally I play with a group, preferably four people is the way to play this game. I'm not a big singles player. Even doubles is not enough people to shield my terribleness. Okay, there's a dude there. He's racing that way. So I'm going to turn. Head in another direction. I don't see anybody else heading for this house. So maybe I can make it there. Maybe I can make it. I just got to make it over this hill real quick. All right. Stop that. Just land. Alright, so I mentioned before, I don't use the mouse and keyboard. Oh, there's a guy over there. I'm gonna run away. Running away is kind of what I do. That's my survival technique. I figured it out. Like, if somebody gets the first shot on me, they've got a 99% chance to kill me. Whereas if I get the first shot on them, they've got like a 90% chance to kill me. So my best strategy is running and hiding until everyone else is dead. And then I finish number two. That's how it works. Because then I'll meet one other person and they'll shoot me and kill me. It's because of the whole mouse and keyboard situation. I'm not good at it. Even though, as I was going to say before I saw that dude, even though I invented the mouse and keyboard strategy for first-person shooters. You may not believe me, but that's fine because it's not true. But in the early 90s, there was a game called Marathon. And I used to play it called versus against my brother-in-law, and this was in the area, this was in the time frame post-Doom, but pre-Quake, I believe, is what it was. So people still played first-person shooters, because they're fairly new, but people still played first-person shooters. Ah, the door's open. These doors are open. There's people here. I'm going to die. They still played first-person shooters with Doom-style controls, meaning they used the arrow keys to move around left and right, and they didn't use the mouse and keyboard. There's a guy. I see a guy running on the horizon towards that building. There's so many people around here. I didn't jump away from the plane far enough. Basically, in order to get any kind of verticality to your player or to your vision, you would use the keyboard, like the Z key and the C key and the whatever, the V key would change your axis. Somebody's shooting. Not at me, though. Hope there are holes in this fence, but I don't think there are. There are not holes in this fence. There's going to be people in here. I'm going to die, but that's fine. So that's how people controlled first-person shooters, with the keyboard, not using the mouse. And then I was playing my brother-in-law. We played a bunch of death matches against each other. We got a shotgun. I got a Molotov. I'm all set. And he kept beating me, and I couldn't beat him because he was just... He was older than me, he was better than me, whatever, he played the game more than me. So I started looking around for some advantages I could get on the keyboard, and I went into options, and I saw on the options... Oops, somebody's shooting at me, somebody's shooting at me. I got a kill. I got a kill. Suck it, Trebek. I got a kill. Now he blasted the crap out of me. Blasted the crap out of me, but doesn't matter because I got a kill. Alright, I'm not going to waste my time with his stuff. Even though he has some shotgun shells I could probably use. But okay. So anyway, I went around looking in the controls, and there was this thing that's, you know, a button you could click to say use mouse for the vertical controls or whatever. It said, like, use mouse to look around, whatever. So I clicked on that, and I started using the mouse to look around. I could look up. I could look down. And the Marathon map was one of the first to have verticality to it. It had, like, steps, and it had floors with two levels in it. So I would just go up on one of the second levels, use the mouse to look down on him, and started blasting him and started winning. So this was probably like 1992, 1993, somewhere around there. Maybe 1991. I'm not exactly sure. But it was sometime early 90s, and I'm pretty sure that I'm one of the first people to ever use it, other than, of course, the people who created Marathon and put that little setting in the settings. But other than those people, ooh, somebody's shooting. What's this? Ooh, police vest, level 2. All right, I need heals. I need heals real bad. And I need to check. All right, I'm going to squat down here in the dirt. I need to check the map. I need to see where the circle. Oh, I'm in the circle. I'm not in the circle. I'm way outside the circle. The circle is west, far to the west. I need a car, and I'm not going to make it. They're going to restrict the circle real soon. All right, so I got a kill, but I'm going to die. I don't see any cars this way. I don't think there are usually any cars around here. Maybe there's a motorcycle spawn somewhere. I thought I saw a car out on the road, but I'm not going to make it there before I get electro-zapped. I'm going to run through this building real quick, see if there's any heals in here. I don't have a backpack. I do have armor. I don't have a helmet. I don't have nothing. That's the thing about the one-player game, is you don't have anybody there to remind you, like, hey, we need to go, we need to check the circle. Plus, I'm talking. And that doesn't help. But anyway, I'm still happy I just got a kill. I mean, that's pretty good for me. I think somebody took that car that I saw. Because I thought it was right here at this bend. But it could have just been an optical illusion. Anyway, either way, things aren't looking good. Ooh, what's that? What's that? That's a bush. I thought it was a buggy, but I think it's a bush. Got my 4 shotgun shells here. Nope. Nothing's happening. I can't stop and loot, but I'm going to stop and loot. Is that a cart? That's not a cart. Yeah, that's the thing about playing singles. Like, you think, oh, I'll get all the loot to myself. But you also don't have, you know, four people running around saying, hey, I found this in this building. Do you have it? And, you know, teamwork, cooperation, right? That's how the world goes around. That's what makes life worth living, is teamwork and cooperation and friendship and rainbows. Ooh, shotgun shells. And shotgun shells and lag. See, this game is already kind of laggy, so when I'll grab this pistol just for fun. Did I grab it? I grabbed it. I forgot I had a Molotov. What was I saying? Something about friendship. Oh, come on. Load. All right. I lost my train of thought. Oh, yeah. You know, you can spread out. You can find more stuff. Even though when you're by yourself, you can get all of it that you find, but you just don't find enough of it, so you don't have, you know, especially if you run into early encounters, you don't have anything on you. Is that a motorcycle, or is that a... That's a rock. The garage here, no cars. This is all warehouse stuff. I'm gonna get electrocuted. I'm not even running in the right direction. I believe I'm running in the exact opposite direction of where I should be going. I should be going west. I mean, I'm 1,000 miles away. I know I should be running east. There's the electricity. Okay, so this is going to be a failed first attempt, obviously, because they're all going to be failed first attempt. Ooh, there's a dude. But I'm going to get 2 kills. Yeah, take that, Trebek. Number 41 with 2 kills. I mean, it's not a success, but for me, it's a success getting 2 kills. One of them was an AFKer, but that's fine. That still counts as far as I'm concerned. So there you go. Oops, don't want to exit the match just yet. There you go. There's our first edition of Late Night Battlegrounds with Zebu Nation. We got a fun little story out about how I invented mouse and keyboard controls, even though I reject them now in my old age. But, yeah, there we go. 2 kills. Number 41. We'll see if in future episodes I can best that number. But it's highly doubtful. Anyway, see you next time.